Dr. Eugene Bestman, I am a first-year resident at ChristianaCare in oral and maxillofacial surgery. What is oral and maxillofacial surgery? So, oral and maxillofacial surgery, as its name implies, it's surgery. It's a surgical specialty in the field of dentistry with a focus on the mouth and basically the face. So, all the bones in the face. We deal with fracture of the jaws of the face or any facial bone. Bread and butter is dental extraction. So, we do wisdom teeth extractions. Implants, bone grafting, infections of the face, deep space infections, dental abscesses and stuff like that. We also do reconstructive surgery, orthodontic cases. We work really, really close in hand with different specialties in dentistry like orthodontics and the prosthodontists. Trauma, so we repair broken jaws, and then also there is some fellowships in oral surgery that deal with cancer as well, so squamous cell carcinoma, basal cell carcinoma, and then there's a craniofacial specialty as well. So there's a lot and lot of things, and it's a very broad scope specialty. We work alongside even ENTs and plastic surgery. We repair lacerations. I mean, there's so many things that an oral maxillofacial surgeon does. I could spend an hour going and explaining this, but in a nutshell, we're like plastic surgeons that can extract teeth.
Why did you decide on oral maxillofacial surgery as a career choice?
My journey to oral surgery is a bit different than most people. I wasn't exposed to the field till when I moved to the United States. I had a childhood experience back when I lived in Ghana, where I'm from, that pretty much led me to an oral surgeon. I long story short, I slipped and fell, and then I chipped my tooth, and I didn't really have the access to care at the time, and so I ended up losing the tooth. But when I moved to the States, my general dentist referred me to an oral surgeon, and that was when I discovered the field, knowing that I could get implants to replace that tooth. It was very intriguing to me, so I ended up going home. Even though I didn't get the implant placed at the time, I ended up going home and really doing a lot of research into the field, and I found, as I continued to learn about it, I fell in love with what they do. And I also have a mentor, actually the same surgeon that I went to when I was 16, that I was referred to. I actually have the luxury of working with him now. But basically, from that time onward, I ended up pursuing dental school and then continuing my journey and my passion for oral surgery.
What is the compensation for oral maxillofacial surgeons in the nation?
Kind of depends on where you are. I think location plays a role as well, and just there's a lot of factors, but I would say a rough estimate is about 300,000, but it could go, it could go anywhere from that to upwards in the 500s. And
what is the value of mentorship, and how has it helped you?
So mentorship to me is very important. I don't think I would be where I am right now if it wasn't for the mentors that I had in my life throughout my journey. So I think mentorship is really key for a young, for any person in any field looking to pursue a career in any field. Having someone that has the knowledge and can guide you to make certain decisions or prevent you from making other decisions is usually pretty instrumental. And I can speak from my experience. As I mentioned, I have a lot of mentors, one including the oral surgeon that actually inspired me to continue this journey. And I actually have the luxury of still working with him now that I'm at Christiana, because he is one of the faculty members here. So it's nice to see how it came around full circle, that the same person that I got that introduced me to the field, I am now basically working with as a resident at ChristianaCare.
What's the percentage of minorities in your field? Do you think we need more minorities?
pulled some stats from the website, from PubMed, and there's 349 OMFS faculty in the nation. 71% are white, 6.9% are black, and then 5.1% are Hispanic, and 19.9% is Asian. And then out of the 991 residents in the nation, 70.7% are white, and then 4.3% are black, and 4.2% is Hispanic, and then you have 19, almost 20% that are Asian. And so there is definitely a disparity in terms of the provider to patient population that are treated. So the percentage of black oral surgeons are pretty low, and that's something that I think needs, you know, we need to, I guess, have more outreach. And I'm in a position where I can also be a mentor and also be an example for people to look into the field. Yeah. I think it can be demanding at times, but definitely impactful.
What is a typical work day like?
A typical work day, so I wake up at 4:30 in the morning every day, and then I have to round on my inpatients. So these are the patients that are in the hospital overnight for people that might not know much about hospital stuff. But I round on them for between the hours of 5 to 7 a.m., and then I have to report back in our outpatient facility, and then me and the rest of the team, we sit down and we discuss all the patients, and we discuss kind of the plan moving forward in terms of their treatment. And then from 8 a.m. to about 4 or 5 p.m., I'm in the outpatient clinic doing outpatient procedures such as extractions, biopsies, alveoplasty procedures. We're also working patients up, patients that were seen in the emergency department that may have sustained some sort of facial fractures. So we're also working them up and preparing them for surgery. And then I also work closely with my general dentistry residents in treatment planning and diagnosing as well, for implants, bone grafting procedures, and so many things that we do. So my day is pretty much from 4:30 a.m. on a typical day to I leave the office probably around 6 p.m. But if I'm on call, then that means I'm the resident on call for the rest of the night. So it can pretty much go all night if depending on how busy things are.
What's your advice for those thinking of pursuing a career in your field?
I would say definitely, if this is something that you're interested in, you should look into, there's a few things you should do first, would be my recommendation. Network as best as you can, get some mentors, it's very important, that can, again, guide you and point you in the right direction. But I would say shadow, try to get experience. There's externships you can do while you're in dental school. Even before you get to dental school, there's a bunch of, find a local oral surgery practice that you can maybe go in there and just kind of get your hands wet in things and kind of see what your life is going to be. So I think exposure, gain a lot of exposure in the field as much as you can, because this is one of the fields that if you don't know what you're getting yourself into, you may be overwhelmed in the beginning.
Are platforms like these relevant? If yes, why?
Zebralter is a wonderful organization, an not-for-profit organization with the aim of kind of shedding light on black scientists in STEM. And I think having organizations like this is really good, because it's able to, for whoever that might be considering a career in whatever field that's being talked about, it's nice to see someone that may look like them that can show them that, hey, this is also possible. You can do this no matter what anyone tells you. You have all the tools within you. As long as you put your mind to it and it's something that you want to do, you can do it. And I'm I'm here and I'm a living witness, and I'm want to be able to pay it forward and inspire whoever that may be looking forward to. So I'm glad that I have this platform to be able to share my story and share my experiences and also inspire the next generation.
What are your final words about your journey toward becoming an oral and maxillofacial surgeon?
I initially decided to do this because, I had a personal experience that led me to the field. But while being in here, it's actually showed me really the impact that I have on my patients and what I'm able to do. I was looking at some statistics, and I'm in Delaware, and there's 12 oral surgeons in Delaware. I don't know how many oral surgeons there are in the nation. So the impact that I'm able to have being with my skill sets on my patients, and yes, sometimes we have complex treatment plan and complex things, but it's amazing to be able to really change someone's life. So that's something that I've experienced more now that I'm in the field, and it definitely brings me more joy, more fulfillment.